What's up, everybody? James, Nair Vids channel. And, sick today. I'm not at school, so I figured I'll just come out here and make a quick vid. It'll be part 6 of the golf cart build, another update. Now, immediately, what do you see? Paint. I know. It's beautiful, but give it some nice paint, so now it's amazing what paint will do. You see, I have the bumper on. Couple things, but now the big thing. Well, as you can see, I'm in the middle of trying to do the electrical. I'm getting the exhaust in. Gonna be badass. Haven't been working on it in weeks. Well, maybe a week and a half. But this is the tent that I put up. And as you can see, there's been modifications because it rained. And I don't know about you, but tent, usually the bar isn't supposed to be like that. It rained, the water collapsed this bar. So I have to go get a new bar and put it in. They even bent this bar. How's that, huh? That just shows how much it rained. Threw all my shit out over here. Luckily, it didn't get wet under here though, so my electrical was okay. So, but, get back to the golf cart here. So, you know, did everything. You guys have seen it. I got the brakes, I got the shocks in. Working on electrical, I put this bar in to hold up my coil pack for this because it needs to be closed because these are short wires. I've got everything in, but I don't know, I tried it out and there's no spark. Turns over and everything, but no spark, so it's weird, but I'm sure it was really cool. Now, I left off last video telling you that I had a plan for how I was going to connect this, the shifter, to the kick shifter.
No. Yeah, I'm just making a quick video of it. Put it on YouTube. No, I'm sick today. I'm actually sick, believe it or not. Actually, I'm not feeling good.
Okay, back to what I was doing. That was Karen, she's really nice. But, yeah, like I said, the shifter, left it off and saying that I had a plan on how I was gonna connect it. But I didn't tell you, because it was gonna be a surprise. Well, there it is. You can see that, but this is the shifter. I took it off and made it face down. And I've got this conglomeration of joints. Now I've got this bar, which moves back and forth, forward to back, when you pull this. Now that's pretty easy to understand. This is on a joint right here. And then this bar is connected to a joint just below that. You can see this is the bar, and this is the joint. Now I had to extend the rod because it wasn't long enough. But, you know, when you do this, it goes back and forth. Now when you push it, when you pull back, this shifts up. Up. Now when you pull it, let me switch about this bad camera work, I know. But when you pull it back, get a shot. You pull it back, you can see how it does that. It pulls this. Now this piece of metal and this piece of metal are one. They're an L. Right? I welded it together. So they're an L. So you get it, right? And then there's a bolt welded onto the bottom of, to the underside of this that's bolted to. So when you pull this back, if you're blind and you can't actually see how simple it is, when you pull it back, it converts motion going that way, going in that direction, going in that direction, into motion going in that direction, through that L bracket. And then that motion going that way is what twitches gears. Right now in second, now in neutral, you know, so very nearing to first test. Once I can figure out why it's not sparking for some reason, I will be able to give it a test and I will be able to see what the hell is the problem, you know. So I don't know, I have to get an expert opinion on what the hell is going on with it. I've tried everything. It's Sparkle yet. I tested everything. Why? It doesn't work. So, I don't know. Might be the coil packs, might be something else, might be this voltage regulator, the ignition. Who the hell knows? Gotta figure it out. Get the meter out here and test if we even have current going here. Because I don't know. Now when you turn this on, the light doesn't even come on anymore. You say it's a neutral. So, work still to be done. Otherwise, everything is still the same. Gas. Oh yeah, gas pedal is now hooked up. I don't know if you guys can see that in there. You got that hooked up now. Brake is still the same. Right, and the clutch pedal has been tightened. But it's still the same. Then all the shit up here, for lack of a better place to put everything while I was working on it. And see, this weld cracked because I had to bend this bar down, so I just put another weld over the top of that. So whatever, that concludes this. Deny Rids production. Keep watching, because it's not going to be long before this thing is going to a street near you. Just kidding. No, it's not going to be long until I test it and I can video that. And also, I got a new pistol. No, it's not a real pistol, sadly, but I mean, I've been saving my money for a really good gas blowback airsoft gun. Gay to some people. It's still fun. You go around my neighborhood scaring people. But it's good. It's an M9 Beretta full metal gas blowback. Spent good money on it. It worked good, so I'll make a video of that later on. But right now, I gotta go. Still sick. Gonna go rest. So, rate, comment, subscribe. Deny Vids. Thank you very much.